Robin had worn the jersey on the Saturday afternoon before the shootings, and on Sunday had been wearing the tracksuit top and bottoms he was wearing when killed. David had some startling new information to add to his account of the night before the shootings. He said he could recall waking up during the evening and hearing raised voices coming from the living room. "Usually, I mean, I am able to sleep right through, because you can't even hear the TV from my room. I was not able to hear anything being said, it was just raised voices, that was all." He also had a much fuller account of what had occurred when he'd got home from his paper round. He now remembered going into Stephen's room. "I can only remember seeing Stephen and that he was covered in blood, his face was red. He looked as if he had blusher all over his face and down his neck. In his room, I can't remember seeing anything else, just him. I touched him. I got down beside him and touched his shoulder to see if I could wake him, but he didn't move at all, and then I left the room. I can't remember walking through anywhere else, but the next thing I remember is being in Laniet's room, and I could hear her gurgling. I could see blood all over her face and on the pillow. I can't recall if I touched her. I went right up beside the bed. I must have left the room at that stage, I don't recall it. The next thing I remember is I was down in Ottawa's room. I saw her face. She was on the floor. I can't recall how close I got to her. I didn't touch her, not that I can remember anyway. Ottawa appeared dead. She was white. She was just white, pasty. I don't remember. I don't remember leaving the room, but I remember going into the lounge and I saw my father there. I went up beside him, but he wasn't awake either.